Hello everyone, this is Gamer, and welcome back to Life is Strange Before the Storm. Let's continue with your last off, shall we? Well, we finished the whole game, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
Now, there's one more episode we have to finish. There's a bonus episode called Farewell. So, let's do this. Ooh! The loading symbols change. It's look nice. Yarr!
Ready?
I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing.
I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor.
Trust in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Oh my goodness.
Tell me that wasn't the coolest thing you've ever seen!
That was amazing.
That was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome?
That's like asking, why are puppies cute? Some things just are.
I'm not sure your mom would see it that way.
When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
So we're playing as young Max now. This is awesome.
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over. In a few days, my whole family moves to Seattle. I have no idea when I'll see Chloe again. This could be my last chance to say goodbye. But how do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
Bonus episode, Farewell. Life is Strange Before the Storm.
I better help Chloe with her cleaning. And while I'm at it, I can take one long last look around this place. Let this box of trash be a sacrifice to you, oh almighty Chloe Bear. Chloe and I haven't played this game in forever, and I'm pretty sure it's missing pieces.
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Chloe. We haven't played this game in years, and it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max, but you can't erase your shame that easily.
I can see why Chloe has such a hard time cleaning out her room.
I know, right?
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but...
How sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out.
Mm-hmm.
How about you? Any new moves?
Totally.
Yeah, totally. I've been working on my air guitar.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts.
All right, back to the junk mines.
All right, next one. Unicorn poster.
Chloe's always preferred imaginary animals to real ones. Oh, besides Bongo, of course.
Clothes pile.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Duh. Comic strip.
Chloe's had this hung up on her wall forever, but neither of us can figure out what happened to the last panel. I hope Dr. Kloenstein's okay.
Let's hope so. It's left as a cliffhanger, huh?
Chloe keeps trying to get me to hop on her board. I'd rather take pictures. Chloe's such a nerd. She hangs on to all her old textbooks and school supplies.
I guess I'm a nerd too, because I do the same exact thing.
Whoa. Talk about embarrassing.
Oof.
How about these boy band trading cards? Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
And yet, our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
I guess these really are pieces of our past. Then again, so is this whole room.
Hoodie. No. Look at the hoodie.
Chloe's had this hoodie for years. It's her favorite. I don't think she'd mean to throw it away.
What are you doing?
Your favorite hoodie. You must have thrown it in by mistake, right?
No. It's fine. It's filled with holes and falling apart.
That never stopped you from wearing it before.
It's fine. Really.
Oh well, worth a shot. That hoodie actually does look cool. I need a hoodie like that. I need a hoodie with a griffin or a dragon on it.
We bought this as a gag years ago. I honestly can't believe Chloe still has it. What about this half-eaten jawbreaker? A serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be a quitter.
Lick it.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
Duh!
Chloe's been beating me for a while, but that growth spurt could come any day now.
Yep. Mr. Sharky!
I think Chloe used to call this guy Mr. Sharky. I doubt she plays with it anymore.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care? If you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
Firecracker remains.
That was awesome. Who else but Chloe could turn cleaning her room into a pyrotechnical adventure? No messing with Mr. Sharky. People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool.
Acceptance letter.
I bet Chloe's parents were freaking out when she got this letter.
Wow.
I still can't believe you're a Blackwell Academy student. How is it?
Oh, the classes are incredible. The teachers are actually smart. And the lab is legit. Petri dishes for days.
What about the students? Are they as stuck up as you thought they'd be?
They're fine.
I like how the music changed. It's different music. I like this. September 21st, 1995? Wow. That's a year after I was born. And I was born in September, too. Also, my birthday's coming up. I just realized that. Yeah, this is a different intro music. Anyway, back on topic. Should I push further or should I just say nothing?
Chloe, you're terrible at hiding your feelings. Is everything okay?
I don't know, I like hanging out with normal people. Like you.
Thanks. I guess.
You know what I mean. I hate fake people. You're real.
Thanks.
Nobody likes fake people. I don't either. Fake people are the worst. Except this letter. Ooh, camera.
Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
Max is such a camera nerd. Magic!
I was lucky to survive Chloe's magic phase with all my fingers intact.
Dope!
This seems like a good candidate.
Are you insane? That's my entire magic collection. Do you know how many weeks of allowance this cost?
You haven't touched these since the 5th grade talent show.
Maybe because my assistant turned out to be squeamish at the sight of fake blood.
At least you didn't saw me in half. How are you planning to clean this place if you won't throw away anything?
A magician never reveals her secrets. Put it back.
Fair enough.
I guess Chloe wants to keep the magic alive.
Yep.
As usual, Chloe's grades are better than mine. I still kick her butt in PE, though.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Max is a C average student, isn't she? I forgot. Yeah, Chloe used to get A's before she went all downhill and got F's. A D, I think? Yeah. Doll said,
"Live fast, die young, and go out with a bang." Rest in pieces, doll.
Live fast, die young. That sounds like the motto of Club 27. Every celebrity that dies at the age of 27. You live the fast life, enjoy the moment, and then you die young. Fast living, but depressing.
It's so hard to believe. This room, this house, this town, all in the past now. Or soon to be. Who even am I without Chloe? She's the one who's always starting things, pulling us into adventures. I can't imagine life without her. Maybe I haven't told her I'm leaving yet because I still can't believe it's real myself.
Any other dialogue? Ah, this is beautiful. I think that's about...
I've tried my best to clean this place. I should check in with Chloe now.
Yeah, that's the only thing I could do. I looked at everything.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
Oh. Oh no. Should I tell her that I'm leaving now or later? If I tell her now, she'll be upset and that'll just kill the whole mood. But if I do it later, we'll have a good time, and then I can tell her. She'll be sad, but at least she can feel somewhat appreciative. I mean, not appreciative, somewhat, what's the word I'm looking for? Somewhat accepting, because we just had a good time, and she shouldn't be mad over a good time, right? So I'll tell her later.
The possibilities are endless. Got anything in mind?
Actually, you bet your ass I do. I found this when I was digging around before you got here. You're gonna flip! Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, it looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! Ye have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia! Captain Bluebeard and Longmast Silver!
You were such dorks.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
to mine eyes, but two fair pirate wenches.
What? Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project!
Oh, project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in 5. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure ye seek, ye've come to the right place. But be forewarned, the journey will be treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And... Why?
Dude. That was...
hilarious. We were so, so ridiculous.
We still are, Max. We still are. Okay, okay. Forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
Okay, here we go. Property of Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. Ah. Okay. Nice. Pogo the Pirate. Aw, that's cool. The whole gang. Pirate rules. No bathing. No boys on the ship. No sharing pirate secrets. Always share plunder. Always bury treasure. Always protect fellow pirates. Failure to obey these rules will result in plank walking. Another day of plunder and destruction on the high seas. Our just buried treasure has come under attack again. The evil commander Shelley, enemy to all pirates, has threatened to take the map from us if she sees it. Surely she has heard how valuable our treasure is and wants to steal it from us. We are doing our best to keep the keeping the map hidden as we continue to work on it. Because our enemies want our treasure so bad, we must make sure the map is only readable to us, Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver. To more plunder and riches, Captain Bluebeard, Long Max Silver. Skull.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map.
It might be.
Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
All right. Time to find this map.
All right.
Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude. Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try.
Oh, no achievement? It's okay. Make your own story.
I remember writing this. It's a story where you choose what happens. Wonder if I could still get to the end.
Max and Chloe's sewer adventure. Aw. Pet the squirrel? Don't pet the squirrel. You are very... it crossed out stupid brave. You leap down to the sewer. Thankfully, there's a pile of trash, blah, blah, blah. Left for page 9, right for page 7. Aw. If you don't like squirrels, they are so cute and nice. You must be very mean. The squirrel seems annoyed that you ignored her. Uh-huh. That squirrel stole my book report. Down to the sewers again, huh? These are nice drawings, by the way. Shoot. Draw better than me. Just turns around, you run out the window and chase the squirrel. That is a very bad thing to do, and you hope that you don't get in trouble later, but you probably will. Don't matter. You need your book report. Oh! You run away like a scary cat. I don't blame you. That thing is gross. Sewer hole looks pretty scary, but is there another way down? Whoosh! No, it's whoosh! Next thing you know, you are in the sewer again, following the tiny footprints. Uh-oh. Looks like they're going to make a meal out of you today. Oh, no. You picked right. I mean left, which was right. It's confusing. In fact, he's dead. He would kill the poor squirrel. What do you do? Rip, you decided not to chase the squirrel. When the time comes to present your book report, the squirrel stole away. She doesn't believe you. Remember, she told you she doesn't believe you. Why didn't you listen? Blah, blah, blah. I guess you should pay attention. Ooh. Oh, no. Until next time. This is so inventive, Maxine and Chloe, but next time, please do the book report you were assigned.
Oh, yes. Take that, Rat King.
Yes.
People say a lot of things about the Prescott family, but this is pretty cool. It's so hard to believe. This room.
Oh, it's the same dialogue. Okay. I thought she was going to say something different. If she doesn't, cool. If she does, my bad. Oh, that's.
Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder if the map is mixed in with her school supplies from that year.
100%. Great job as always, Chloe. Now please try to pay attention in class instead of drawing pictures with Maxine. I mean, Chloe did do her job. She did her homework. She got 100%. I'm just saying, teacher. I think she's doing pretty good. And besides, you need to have social interaction anyway. Oh.
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour. I think this was the first class Chloe and I had together. Not sure I learned much about the Stars and Stripes. Bingo.
Ah. Treasure Island. Price Castle, Chloe's Secret Lair, Dark Cavern.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? You need the telescope and the amulet,
which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Ugh, why did we do that to ourselves?
Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
Was. Your attic is still terrifying.
It's been 5 years, Max. I'm sure the boogeyman has died of starvation.
It's more the mice and spiders I'm afraid of.
Time to face your fears, then.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Max Silver ride again, bitches!
Oh my god.
Chloe seems so into this. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure.
Aw.
Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet.
Right, give me a moment.
I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back.
Oh, okay. Picture.
I can't believe I won't be able to call Arcadia Bay home much longer. I slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
I know, right? What a ride or die fan.
I don't think I've ever actually seen anyone reading these books.
Nope. Did I say fan? I meant what a ride or die friend. I'm sorry. What the hell am I thinking?
I wonder if I'll ever take this view in again.
Maybe.
I don't think I could ever handle a real-life murder investigation.
Yeah, that would be interesting.
I always like to imagine I could open that wardrobe and step into another world.
A Narnia reference.
The Two Whales makes the best Belgian waffles. No other diner could even come close.
I can't think of any good waffle places besides waffle makers at hotels like Hilton. Heck yeah.
Aww. Chloe's parents are so cute.
Nicotine gum.
Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking.
At least she's trying.
Is that an email from the principal at Blackwell? Chloe did act a little strange when I asked her about school earlier. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. I wonder what about. Did Chloe get into a fight? She never gets in trouble. I'm glad her dad stood up for her. A voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings.
Plane tickets.
Chloe hasn't mentioned a trip. Maybe it's supposed to be a surprise. Oh, so cool. Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it.
I know, right?
Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time? It's awesome that Chloe's mom wants to teach kids. She'd be really good at it.
Yeah. Aw. Happy face. Anything else in here? No? Okay, let's move on. Bathroom. Oh.
It seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
Yep.
Makeup is great for acting in Halloween costumes. Any other time, I just don't get it.
Aw, Max is a natural owl.
The things inside this cabinet haven't changed very much over the years. Chloe's mom bought me a toothbrush because I spend the night here so often. Well, I used to.
Oh, used to, huh?
I guess Chloe never really grew out of wanting to be a pirate.
Alright, broom closet, here I come.
The entrance to the dark cavern is in there. Bluebeard's chosen hiding place for the mysterious amulet. There it is. The dark cavern. Crap. I can't get into the attic if I can't even reach the door. I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
A stepladder. Or maybe this single crate.
Maybe the this'll make me tall enough to reach. It's a start. I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
No. There's gotta be something in the parents' room, right? Aha! Step stool!
This won't be big enough for me to reach, but maybe I can stack things on top of it. Almost there. I just need a few more inches.
Really? The last thing they use, then. Wait. Oh, it says toolbox. I don't know at this point. What can I use?
I just need a few more inches to reach the attic.
I know, but what do I use? I could use this chair, but the chair's not an option, though.
Slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
I know, right? Alright. Oh, Chloe's room.
Chloe's room has always been home base. It's hard to think this might be the last game we ever plan here. I've gotta find that amulet before I meet Chloe out back.
Damn it, what do I use? Can I just...
Not bad for an improvised stepladder, but it's still not tall enough.
Really? I guess you're that short, Max. Oh no, like seriously, I don't know, I might have to look... If I can't figure it out, I might have to look it up because I don't know. Where else can I get...
Maybe I could stand on some books.
Oh! Well, thanks for saying that.
If I stack a bunch of books on the stool, I could probably reach the attic.
Thanks for saying that, Max. Never mind, I don't have to look it up.
I think that should be tall enough. Should be stable enough. Besides, what's adventure without a little risk?
Yep. Careful. Here we go. Oh, it does look creepy up here. Oh, spider! One of my little sisters is terrified of spiders. Yeah, awesome.
Man, there is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever... There it is. Of course, Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to get to. I need to find a way through. The amulet looks kind of cool from the side.
A note from Chloe and Max. Get the amulet. Oh, we started here. Then we're going to go. Oh, okay. I see what's going on.
No Sharpie boob jobs. Disappointing.
Three till. Why is Max in stealth mode? Why does it make you feel like a horror movie?
I remember it took this thing like 100 years to rewind the land before time.
Oh, such a throwback movie right there.
Her parents couldn't part with this. I guess I see where Chloe gets her sentimentality from. I can't get through with this chair here. I think I can squeeze through now. Not a single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom.
Fish tank.
I remember this. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack.
God, the music here is very unsettling.
It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kinda difficult. That's full of decorations Chloe made when she was 5. She thinks they're embarrassing, but I think they're cute.
Cooler.
I need to move that cooler, but this desk is in the way.
Okay, so we have 3 things to push.
I need to move that desk, but this dresser is in the way. Keep it moving, desk.
Oof.
Crap.
I know, right? That's the worst. You're like, ow! And then, ow!
It's more in the way now than when it started.
Ah, damn it. Oh, that's not...
You have to go back. I've got to get through, which means this desk has got to move. One step closer.
Nice.
This thing is empty.
Uh-oh.
I'm so close, but I still can't get to the amulet.
Cool.
Finally. fitting reward for a journey full of treasures. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
Nothing can stop the mighty blue beard.
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And spiders.
Yeah.
Ha ha! I have you now, Skellywag.
Man, I'm gonna miss her.
Yeah. All right, I think that's enough.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
I'm just getting some light. This cavern is even darker than I remembered.
Did you conquer your fears?
You could say that.
Awesome. Now get your ass down here. We have treasure to find.
On my way. No big deal.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. It's not that I don't like the blue. I'm just sad to see the old color go. One time, we stuck a bunch of this tape to Chloe's face to make a blue beard. Putting it on was a lot more fun than taking it off. This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something.
Oh, that looks cool. What a nice way to use a tire. Oh, great.
Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard.
Died at the age of 9. Cigarette butts.
I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke.
Yeah.
Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew.
That'll be cool. Ball.
I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting. These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this why I keep pushing off telling Chloe I'm leaving? Because I don't want to ruin this time together.
Yeah, that's why.
How am I going?
What's up, dude?
Bro.
Don't you mean sis?
Maybe I meant nerd. door.
Doofus.
Only doofuses say doofus. Good talk.
How am I gonna tell this to Chloe that I'm leaving? Ugh, that's gonna be rough. Toy soldiers!
Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it... how I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Great art is never appreciated.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me.
Do you drink this?
Yar.
No, not really. I had to fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
I know, right?
Some pirate you are.
Glider swings. The best way to simulate a storm on the high seas. I never understood why it's called a Jolly Roger. How jolly can you be if you're dead?
That's true, but then again, some people don't mind immortality.
Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair.
There was a frame rate moment for a moment there, guys, so sorry about that. I don't know what happened there. That was odd. It's like the game just went from 60 to 30 in like 1 second, and then it's fine.
I'm really gonna miss Price Family Barbecues.
See, like that was a frame rate moment.
All I'm saying is, I've never broken my wrist taking a picture.
Leaf piles.
I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
Look.
I wish I could freeze this moment. I never have to leave it.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Land ho.
Perfect.
Nice. Bring Chloe the amulet.
Wait just a minute. Yar. You must ask permission before setting foot or peg on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
One amulet. Coming right up.
Okay, I think it goes... damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I think I saw some tape.
Thanks, Max.
Just some tape left between us and the treasure.
Granted. Now, where's that tape? I saw it around here. Oh, it's over here.
Score. One step closer to getting that treasure. Whatever it is.
Yeah. Let's go give her the tape. Oh, ah.
If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Yeah, totally. But we're losers together.
If you're a loser, Max, I don't think I want to be cool. It's just... this whole day has made me... feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way. Avast, matey. Have you brought me prize?
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the Seven Seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag. Just like old times. Huh, Max?
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were gonna be pirates forever.
If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah.
Would you like to do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some treasure.
Wait, how am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something?
Here goes nothing. Okay, this drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Okay. With the X, with that, is that a cloud? I'm like, X is supposed to line up with something. Oh.
I think the drawing should turn the real world into something piratey.
Hmm. This looks like the correct way, because there's the ship and stuff.
I think I have the right angle, but where does it line up?
There we go.
Got it.
Yes! You rock! Where is it? Here?
Right.
Okay, take a step right.
No.
No, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
Mine.
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
That is not what we buried.
Huh? What's going on?
What is this?
I don't know. Let's open it.
From Bloody Bill. Who's that?
I'll get the tape player.
Aha. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
I'm pretty sure I know who Bloody Bill is. Ah, Chloe's dad. He's a pirate too, huh?
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Buddy Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you.
Aww.
Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
Ugh.
Chloe's dad's the best.
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive!
Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. To Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you are so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, Maxine.
Dear Chloe, how are you? Summer vacation, favorite animal, favorite food. Ooh, lobster roll sounds good. Favorite class, best friend. How about you? Are you 12? That's all for now.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Hello from 2003. Here's a record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. We have sleepovers once a week. We like extremely salty pretzels. We are in a race to see who can convince our parents to get a pet first. Aw, man, this makes me wish I would have wrote notes to my future self. I mean, my past self. I wish my past self wrote, like, notes to me now. That would have been so awesome. But who knows? Maybe I did. And maybe I haven't found it yet. Your friend forever, Chloe Elizabeth Price.
You were really sweet.
Oh, man. I was really goopy.
I like it.
That's because you're a goop. This is so cool. There's so much to look at.
Is your mom going to mind about this mess?
Dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff.
I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything.
There's so much to examine here. Let's start over here.
Goodbye, Vase. Soon you won't have to worry about me knocking you over anymore. These used to make great pirate swords.
And now these
These used to make great pirate swords.
Let me rephrase myself. Now these are used as guns now. Yes, umbrella guns. Freaking badass umbrella guns.
Chloe's grandparents live in Idaho now. I guess compared to that, Seattle's not so far.
Yeah, Idaho.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it. But if
Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell. This might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
Let's not mess with that yet.
I always look especially short next to Chloe.
Is this the photo? From before? I think so. Ugh.
This is probably the last thing Chloe's mom wants to see after a shift at the diner.
Tidy up. Aw, Max is such a good
Much
friend.
Much better.
Yes. Hey! Hey, at least I'm doing that for you. You're welcome, by the way. Mm-hmm.
That was a good week. I used every possible excuse to be here for breakfast.
Aw. Oh, 2 weeks of free waffles sounds amazing.
We always make so much more of a mess here than at my house. Manga might be the one thing where Chloe out-nerds me.
I know someone in real life who loves manga. Is it manga or manga? Max says manga, but I say manga. Which one's the correct term?
I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
I'm pretty sure Max said it right. I'm, like, messing up here. Oh, no. Capsule.
This container looks like it could last 100 years.
It probably could. Comic panel.
Holy crap. It's the end of that comic in Chloe's room. Oh, this is gross.
Maybe you should come down and power of flight this dude's face off with me. Invention plans.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
Little does Chloe know, Da Vinci already made the chopper. A long time ago, like 1500s. Or was it 1600s? I think it was 1500s, I believe. Like mid-1500s. Flaming finger. Oh, that's cool. Steel and flint flex together to get a flame on your finger. Okay, that's cool. Ray of sunshine. Ooh. I wonder if this is similar to laser guns. Because that could work.
A time capsule was such a good idea.
I know, right? We're geniuses.
I wish I had my own time capsule like that. Predictions.
Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
Yeah. Chloe has visited Antarctica. Max could rave. Come. If she wanted, okay. Both of us are dating your second boyfriend. Duh! Letters.
It actually might be really fun to write letters to Chloe after I move.
Oh, yeah, that'd be a great idea.
Is writing once a week too often? Will I run out of things to say?
No, you can never run out of things to say. There's so much experience out there. So much you can witness.
Recording things was so much fun in third grade.
Kind of wish I recorded myself back then. Maybe that would have helped me with my voice acting skills.
It's good to see you, old friend.
Mr. Billy the Squid.
Ugh, keep messing up my picture.
There are no mistakes in art.
Amulet.
You sure were troublesome to find. That's so cool that Chloe's mom is thinking about this.
That's good. Snow globe.
There. Now you've got something pretty to look at. Hey, little guy. Aren't you cold in there?
Photo album.
I bet there's some really cute photos in there. I wonder if I could recreate this photo with Chloe now.
Probably. That's the only one? Allowance budget.
Looks like Chloe's a lot more responsible than I am with my allowance.
Yeah.
Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things.
Maybe. Oh, that's cool. Aw.
I still haven't told Chloe about my news. I can do that after I finish looking at everything.
Yeah.
This used to be the Rainy Day pirate ship. Hey, what if my being in Seattle finally convinces Chloe to try an MMO?
Yeah, that's another great idea. Wine stain.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago, but I still feel bad about it.
Baseball cap.
I could use this to recreate that old photo of Chloe.
Yes?
Pose for a photo with that? Okay, tip your head back and put your arms out. And a really big smile.
Like this?
It's perfect. Stop moving. Really cute, Chloe.
You're not so bad yourself.
Nice. Talk to Chloe. Oh, we're near the end, aren't we? Yeah. We're at the end where we have to tell her everything. Oh, boy. Tell her what we really got to go through. Well, the only thing left is to sit down.
Chloe looks so content when she's drawing. Is that what I look like when I'm taking pictures?
Take another photo. Pose with Chloe. Photograph Chloe alone.
Take a break for a second.
This artist waits for no
stop.
That was worth stopping for.
Oh, you. All right, this makes talking to Chloe much sadder. Oh, this is a nice photo. The only thing left is to talk to her, sit on this couch, and listen to this voicemail. Yeah.
To you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school at all. I don't know if your daughter is having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be addressed.
Hey, hold on.
Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble like this before.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
You gotta tell me.
Come on. You've gotta tell me what
happened. Yeah, I'm your best friend.
I'm your best friend.
Man, none of this would have happened if I had you around. I wouldn't care what anyone said.
Sorry. I don't mean it's your fault. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner in science. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
Oh.
Is that why you wanted to throw away your hoodie?
Don't worry. I'll keep it.
That really sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Thanks, Max.
Well, that's taken care of. Oh, but oh, that's not going to be the real hurt. The real hurt is when I'm telling her that I have to move. Oof. Sit down. And be humble.
You're such a space hog. Move over.
Oh.
Nope.
I wish this moment could last forever.
Aww. Okay, the real talk. This is where
I'm a little bit hungry. How about you?
I'm okay. Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I'm worrying too much about this move changing things. I love how Polaroid cameras make every photo look a little nostalgic.
Alright, the real talk. Here we go.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly.
Jeez, this jawbreaker is going to last forever. Aw.
This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Oh.
Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Mushiness alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once our parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
Oh, God. I don't know if I should tell her. I don't want to make her upset, but I've held it out too long. I'm sorry, I gotta tell her. Just... Yeah. Here we go.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
Can't we just text each other or something?
My family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay.
You sure? Don't you have, like, my number or something?
Come on, Dorkmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have told you earlier.
I should have just told you earlier. God, I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
Aw.
I thought about telling you this morning, but then I just felt guilty instead.
Well, I'm glad you didn't. Then it would have been hanging over us all day. That's why I didn't bring it up either.
Aw.
Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so...
Me too.
I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together. Even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Oh no, this is the bad news. Yeah. Yep, this is the bad news.
Uh-huh. Black flies on the windowsill. That we are, that we are, that we are to know. Winter stole summer's thrill. And the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land. A dark and plumed estate. Hope it needs a humble hand. Not a fox found in your place.
Chloe's dad's gone, yeah. Ugh, this is terrible. So sad, too. Arcadia Bay Cemetery.
Or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone. Black flies on the window.
He died at 38.
We are, that we are, that we are the whole. Comfort came against my will. Every story must grow old. Still I be a traveler. A gypsy's reins to face. But the road is wearier with that fool found in your place. No man is an island. For this I know. Can't you see, or maybe you were the ocean when I was just a stone? So here we are.
I'm sorry?
Hey, Chloe. This is Max. I guess I just wanted to leave you one more message. Because I know this was the absolute worst time for me to go. I thought maybe if you heard my voice, it could be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit, and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if I never... Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you.
Hmm. Aww.
Goodbye.
Oh. That's rough. That's beautiful and rough at the same time. Is there more? No, that's it. I need to watch something happy after this, because this really put me on the down low. Damn. Almost had tears too. Damn. Ugh. That was beautiful. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching me play Life is Strange Before the Storm. Thank you so much. Since I completed the first Life is Strange game and this Life is Strange game, I'm going to be playing the next one, which is the... What's it called? Captain Spirit? Something like that? Oh god, I messed up. Jeez. Hold on. Hold up, I messed up so badly. I'm going to be playing The Awesome Adventures of Captain Spirit. Thank you. I had to look it up. Sorry, I have a messed up memory. I'm going to play that next, and then after that, we just wait till the release of Life is Strange 2. Yeah. Alright, thank you guys so much for watching me play this, and I'll see you on the next following game. Yeah. Which is The Awesome Adventures of Captain Spirit. Sorry, I'm sounding a little slow today. Ugh. Anywho, bye everyone.